Hello students, today we will study the chapter The Union Parliament. Now before I proceed with the chapter, let us understand what is Parliament. The word Parliament is derived from the French expression Parliament, which means speaking. Now in India, the word Parliament, it refers to the legislative organ of the government. And as we all know, there are three organs, or we can say there are three branches of government, namely legislative, executive and judicial. So Parliament refers to the first organ of the government, that is legislative. Now let's have a look at the syllabus. I'm reading from the syllabus box. In this chapter, we'll cover the following topics: the Union Legislature, meaning of the federal setup in India. Then first we have Lok Sabha, term, composition, qualifications for membership, parliamentary procedures, a brief idea of sessions, quorum, question hour, adjournment and no confidence motion. Then we have Speaker, election and the functions of a Speaker. Then Rajya Sabha, composition, qualifications for membership, election, term and presiding officer. Then we have powers and functions of Union Parliament: legislative, financial, judicial, electoral, amendment of the constitution, control over executive. And lastly, we have exclusive powers of the two houses. Two houses here refers to Lok Sabha and the Rajya Sabha. Now I begin with the chapter Federal Setup in India. The Constitution of India has provided for a federal system of government, though the term federation has nowhere been used in Constitution. Now what is the meaning of federal? See, federal means that there is distribution of powers between the union and the states. Now what happens in a federal system of government? In a federal system of government, all the administrative powers are divided between the central and the state governments by the constitution, and both are supreme within their respective spheres. So you can underline all these lines. So what happens in a federal system of government, girls? The administrative powers, it is divided between center and state. And who has made this division? Who has divided these powers? The Constitution of India. So the Constitution of India has divided the powers between the center and the state governments. And both are supreme. Supreme means they are highest within their respective areas. The state governments are not the agents of the central government, nor do they draw their authority from it. So the state government, they have not been given, they do not draw the authority, they do not get the authority from the central government, but they get it from the Constitution of India. On the other hand, both the central and the state governments draw the authority from the same constitution, that is Constitution of India. India has opted for a federal system of government, though with a strong unitary bias. So though we have Though at the center, we have the central government, and at the state level, we have the different state governments. But still, central and the state governments together, they work with a strong unitary bias. Now, what is the importance of federal setup? Importance of federal setup. First point. India is a large country with 29 states and 7 union territories. It is not possible in the Indian federal system for the states to break away as a separate unit from the Union of India. This is essential for maintaining the unity and integrity of India. Now there's a slight change, girls. Earlier there were 29 states in India and 7 union territories. Now, after the bifurcation of Jammu and Kashmir on October 31st, 2019, now we have only 28 states and 8 union territories. So the latest addition to the union territories list is Jammu and Kashmir. So Jammu and Kashmir, it's no more a state, it is considered as a union territory. And this has been after the bifurcation on October 31, 2019, that is last year. So now we have 28 states and 8 union territories. And the other union territories are Delhi, you have Ladakh, Dadra and Nagar Haveli, Daman and Diu, Puducherry, you have Chandigarh, you have Andaman and Nicobar Islands and Lakshadweep. And the latest addition is Jammu and Kashmir. So it's not possible in the Indian federal system for the states to break away to function in a separate manner. They have to be a part of the Union of India. They cannot function separately. This is essential for maintaining the unity and integrity of India, and this federal setup is very, very important, or it's very essential to maintain the unity and integrity of India. Second point, a federal system is the only system suitable to a country like India, consisting of various types of people. This is of utmost importance if India is to be saved from separatist forces fighting for fragmentation and provincialism of the country. Now, as we all know that India is a very, very vast country, and here it consists of various types of people. Now, what does this various types of people mean? See, various types of people here, it refers to the people belonging to different religion. Then we have caste, creed. And as we travel the length and breadth of the country, we observe that the climate, then food habits and the language and the dress sense of the people, it varies from state to state. And here it is said, this is of utmost importance if India is to be safe from separatist forces fighting for the fragmentation and provincialism of the country. So if India is to be safeguarded from the forces, okay, the outside forces who are trying to break the society into different provinces or state governments, this federal system is very, very important. See, the meaning of utmost, girls, it is greatest. Then fragmentation, it is breaking of society. Provincialism means division into different provinces or states. Third point, there is division of legislative and administrative powers between the union and the state governments, and none of them could violate the limitations imposed by the constitution. So as I mentioned earlier, the legislative powers of the union and the state governments are divided by the constitution, okay, by the constitution of India, and they cannot violate the limitations which has been imposed, which has been enforced by the constitution. And to keep a check on this, we have the Supreme Court. Okay, the Supreme Court, or it is also known as the apex or the highest court in India. The Supreme Court stands at the head of judiciary to safeguard this distribution of powers and to prevent any action which violates or breaks the limitations imposed by the Constitution. So it is the duty of the Supreme Court to keep a check over the center and the state that they do not violate the limitations which has been enforced by the Constitution of India. So the central government in certain matters cannot interfere with the internal affairs of the state government. And both of them, that is the central government and the state governments, they have got supreme power within their respective areas. Now, third point, the states have been given the right to participate in the functioning of the government. India has a bicameral legislature, that is the Lok Sabha and the Rajya Sabha. Bi means two. Okay, so here it means division of legislature into two separate assemblies. Now, which are the two separate assemblies? The Lok Sabha and the Rajya Sabha. And the Rajya Sabha mainly comprises representatives of the state. So at the center, we have the Lok Sabha, and at the state level, we have the Rajya Sabha. Fifth point, no system of federation can be successful unless both the union and the states have adequate or sufficient financial resources to enable them to discharge their duties. So it's very, very important, girls. Financial resources are very important for both central government as well as the state governments. In order to discharge, to carry out their duties, they need adequate or sufficient financial resources. And the Constitution of India has made provisions for the distribution of revenues or income between the center and the state. This distribution has ensured equitable distribution of the financial resources between the two units or the center and the state government. So this Constitution of India has made enough provision for equal distribution of revenue or income between the center and the state. So I stop you, girls, for today. Tomorrow we will study the non-federal or the unitary features of India. Good day.